today, young conservatives are going to join us to react to viral political TikToks, and we're going to get their take on whether or not TikTok should be banned. Up first, we have Morgan Zegers, founder of Young Americans Against Socialism. Morgan, are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
The next person who has the sheer nerve, the sheer entitled caucasity to say all lives matter, I'ma stab you. I'ma stab you. And while you're struggling and bleeding out, I'ma show you my paper cut and say, my cut matters too.
The left is quite violent, and then they're completely unable to see their own hypocrisy in this. And this is like the classic leftist thing. They're, the end justifies the means for them. And so they believe anything that they have to do to achieve this equal, moral, beautiful society, even if it is violence against their opponents, including people on the right, they're willing to do it. And this is just another pathetic example.
I know this is what Trump supporters wanted, because standing up for Black Lives Matter put me in a place online to be seen by millions of people. The job that I had worked really hard to get and meant a lot to me just called me and fired me because of everything. I don't know if everyone's seen, but it's been circulating a lot. My Black Lives Matter TikToks were picked up by conservatives and spread and shared, and people were demanding that I be fired, which I just got.
Okay, so our generation completely lacks the ability to take on self-responsibility. And so if you notice in the beginning, she says Trump supporters took her job from her. In reality, she acted like a child, and a violent child like that, threatening other people's lives over a political issue, put it on the internet, which was a dumb decision. It went viral and people contacted her company. So of course she's going to get fired for her own behavior.
It's very sad actually, because she's crying. And yeah, it's sad that she lost her life and she's saying that she's received all these threats. But that's literally what she did, was she threatened people. And I don't know a single Trump supporter who has that at some point, especially if you are in the limelight. And I'm with three influencers right now that haven't received rape threats, that haven't received death threats, that haven't had people come at them and say, oh, I'm going to kill you, or you don't deserve to live.
Even though they claim to stand against systematic bias, racism, and unequal treatment. So do the thousands of Trump supporters sending me hate messages, death threats, and violent messages. I'm still not going to stop talking about and defending Black Lives Matter. You can't take away my spirit and my devotion towards human rights.
The problem is a lot of people in Gen Z and millennials do not see that connection of their behavior has consequences. And so I think that all plays into that idea of young Americans not supporting the idea of capitalism, because it comes with that requirement of self-responsibility as well.
People on the left will DM you and say, I wish your mom had aborted you. Like, it's insane what people will say. And these are the very people that she stands by. And now she's on that end of it.
I definitely think we have to do something about China having so much power over American data right now through TikTok. And the really exciting thing that I see about this is it's an opportunity for us to explain to young Americans just how bad communist China is, the atrocities that they've committed against human rights. And so hopefully we can actually open the minds of young Americans to seeing how dangerous not only communism, but socialism and Marxism, which are the ideologies that lead to communism, how terrible those things can be. And so I think I see this as an opportunity to start an important conversation, and something definitely has to be done. Hopefully, though, an American company picks up TikTok and we get this fixed, because everybody loves TikTok.